Hey, Sarah, we're outside the bocce ball court. I used to play this when I was little, so I know a thing or two about it. We'll see if I can show off my skills later. But this is a big part of the St. Gabriel's Festival happening here this weekend in Little Italy. We're outside St. Leo's Learning Center. I'm here with Dino Basso, and he is in charge of this tournament. And I know it looks quiet right now, but this is going to be packed this weekend. What are they going to be coming to see?
They'll be coming to see a singles tournament Saturday with 16 players starting approximately 9:30 and it'll last till 7. And then Sunday, they'll be here to see a four-person tournament starting at approximately 9:30 and lasting until approximately 7 o'clock. And they come to see the competition, the keen competition, because we have a lot of competitive teams here that are fairly good.
Oh, and I've been a lot of competition. And bocce ball, big tradition, and a lot of people have been playing this since they were little.
Yes, they have, and it's a big tradition in Little Italy. We have three leagues that play here, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, and we have a lot of people who come down just to watch bocce.
Oh, great. It sounds like great food, great times, and great bocce. That sounds
yes,
like fun.
It is.
Thanks for being here.
Now we check in live again with Ava Marie, bringing us the best of Little Italy. Good morning to you.
Good morning, and Sarah, it's been fun. I played some bocce ball during the break, and I won, so he owes me $20, so I'm going to bank on that. I'm taking him for his word. Anyways, we are here outside the bocce ball court for outside of St. Louis Leo's Learning Center talking about the St. Gabriel's Festival happening this weekend. I'm here with Anthony Moncalmo and president of Little Italy Lodge, one of the organizations helping to make this festival happen. So tell us about everyone who's involved.
One of the nice things about the festival is that it's fun, food, family, all the things we've talked about before. But it's also an example of three large organizations, Italian organizations, coming together to do something as a group. The Little Italy Lodge, the St. Gabriel Congregation, and St. Leo's Church all play a part in putting on the event and getting all the arrangements taken care of. It's just it's a good feeling of community.
Great, thank you, thank you. And I'm also here with Will Matricini, and tell us how you really pronounce your last name.
It's the actual pronunciation, is Matriciani.
Great,
but
great.
Very, very difficult to do.
Your family has a lot of history here.
Yeah, my family dates back here since 1907, and one of the founding members was my grandfather for the Association of St. Gabriel Congregation. So,
great, and quickly, who would you like to thank for making this happen?
I would like to thank all of the volunteers. They make it actually happen. We couldn't do this without all your help, so thank you guys so much. We really appreciate it.
Great, and you owe me $20, Will.
I know.
Tony, we're going to head back to you in the Weather Center, or